chopper motor is probably not oversized because they usually are pretty good sized motors. They put a lot of energy into the product.
One of the things we always have to keep in mind is maybe since they're making their own electricity and not old.
Sugar. Here goes the peanut butter. Running in reverse to a discharge?
Towards the discharge.
Toward the discharge?
Yeah.
Here comes the oil and the vitamin.
You got stuff in the bottom there, George.
Look at that first. Now it's peanuts, oil, sugar, and vitamins. This is adding the milk to the other part of the mixture.
Yeah, it's pretty liquid. We don't care too much since we're just going to another batch.
This is the second batch, and we're putting in the sugar first. Next comes the peanut paste. Okay, this is the oil and vitamin mixture.
This batch looks to be a little more liquid.
Which batch is this?
This is the batch we made when we were
product in. This is the in feed. This is the discharge. It will come up here, and if this valve is shut, the product will circle back in here. This is the back pressure valve, set to a certain pressure. When you open this valve to fill the pouch, the pressure release, the product will come out of here. And when you shut the valve, product will continue in here, so it's a continuing loop of the product.
And this is a prototype,
prototype
of the design that you were talking about the other day.
An operator would be sitting here with a pouch, and there'd be a scale under here, and he would control the flow with this valve, opening and closing this valve. This would happen to be a butterfly valve. So it's not a ball valve, it's got sealed in it, it's strictly a metal-to-metal contact in here.
This is very little back pressure now.